This summer, Absolute Radio Live will be bigger than ever. Coldplay, Elba, Kasabian, Blur, Paul Weller, Florence, I Can't Keep Up, No, Stereophonics, The Stone Roses, and lots more. You'll be with them at this year's biggest live music events when you listen to Absolute Radio Live. We'll take you there.
Absolute Radio backstage at Hard Rock Calling 2012, and I'm joined by the guys from Soundgarden, Chris Cornell and Kim Thayil. Gents, great to meet you. How are you doing?
Good,
great.
Thank you.
Are you guys excited about playing tonight?
Yes.
Very excited.
Yes.
And excited to see the Stooges play, of course.
Very excited.
And to be playing a show in Hyde Park with them.
And what about the English weather? You enjoying the English weather so far?
Very similar to Seattle weather.
It's always like this, yeah.
What is it with Seattle weather? Is it the fog?
It's crappy. It's like English weather.
Or is it mist? Doesn't Seattle have a lot of mist?
Chicago has more annual rainfall than Seattle, but Seattle has this constant pissing down, kind of like London.
Yeah. So you're at home in this?
Yes.
Sure.
Yeah. So, guys, what is it like to be back together? Loads of UK fans looking forward to seeing you tonight. What's it like to be back together again as a band?
It's no different than it was, really, I don't think. I mean, there's some changes. We don't drink as much as we used to.
Yeah.
That's a function of age.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I find with me...
if you survived that age.
But do you still feel like you were when you were 19?
No.
Okay, fair enough.
No.
But I feel like I was when I was 19, but I notice it more when I bend down to pick something up. That's when it really...
The
groan.
Yes.
You stand back up again.
Yes.
I got that. One of my favourite bands of all time, the Stone Roses, I've just been to see them. They've just done a comeback gig.
Manchester band.
And they got together, accidentally all turned up at a funeral, and they got talking. And how did your reconciliation happen?
I guess it was sort of like not a funeral.
No, although we'd been to many, it wasn't that. It was like various meetings talking about starting a fan club again, starting a website again, doing some reissues maybe, which we talked about for a long time and just hadn't got around to it. And then it just kind of naturally came time when we all felt like we should get in a room and discuss doing that stuff. And then over a series of meetings, which was like, I don't know, a year and a half, we discussed maybe doing a show, doing a surprise show, maybe with a few songs, and then it became like doing a whole full show. And then there was talk of doing, you know, maybe we could do a tour. We turned down a lot of shows. But we slowly decided that was okay. And once we were actually in a room playing music, we knew that we could easily come up with at least an album's worth of material.
You know, one of the little obstacles was, Chris had a busy solo schedule, but Matt has a full-time gig with Pearl Jam. So we kind of had to work around that. So we can't do these gigs because of, you know, Matt's going to be in another continent. And we're going to maintain our incontinence.
Incontinence.
Yes.
Yeah, I like that approach.
That's part of the age.
Yeah, going back to the age thing. So what can Soundgarden fans expect tonight?
A pretty in-depth set list that includes songs as
from
far back
Fog
as...
From Foghat, Fool for the City?
Yeah. So we are actually doing a couple Stone Roses songs.
Are you
ready? You know, the live album we put out... Actually, the live album we put out last year...
Yeah.
You know, we did a Stooges song.
That's true, we did.
Raw Power's on Live on I-5. Search and Destroy is on Live on I-5, sorry. We're not going to be able to play it tonight because we're going to go watch them do it right.
Yeah.
You know. I am excited about that. That's one of my three favorite bands.
So what's it like to re-engage with the fans after a break, after that period of time?
Well, it's some of the same fans and a lot of different ones.
And a lot of their sons and daughters.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's actually a lot of kind of young rock fans that maybe they heard about it from their big brothers and sisters or parents or who knows what, that now, you know, because we've got back together and are touring, have a chance to see us live. And also I feel like there's a lot of young rock fans that are doing what I did at 15, 16, 17, which is... listen to older bands and find records and dig stuff up that people talk about, and so that, you know, it's a different group.
For instance, when I was a teenager, and I started getting into the Stooges or the MC5, they'd already been broken up for like 3 years.
Yeah.
So I found out about them through reading about them or hearing a friend's older brother's collection or whatever. Yeah. And I took to them, you know, immediately. And so we're meeting a lot of young musicians, you know, young guys who are into guitar and drums, guys of bands who perhaps were acquainted with us. Same thing, older brothers, fathers, mothers. And so that's exciting for us.
Yeah.
We always want it to be, you know, relevant for young musicians as we were. If we're speaking to people as we responded to music growing up, then I think we're doing the right thing and reaching the audience, which are like younger versions of us. I think we're being honest with ourselves if we're doing that, and I think we have.
And one last question. We've got the Olympics in London very, very soon. Would you guys want to stay around and watch the Olympics? Are you into the Olympics? Does it interest you?
Personally, I might be practicing a pole vault later.
I'd like to see you do that.
Well, no.
About
this
the
is
last
a,
thing
this
you
is,
do.
This is a solitary event.
Walk.
I would. Wouldn't that be amazing? It's not too late to try and get you know, be part of Team GB. Kim, are you up for it?
I love the Olympics, but like the last thing I would ever want to do is go in person to an Olympic event in any country in any city ever. Like the traffic. Crowds,
yeah.
Tickets,
security.
Seat numbers, to see one event. That doesn't make any sense. You can watch it on TV and see all the events and like go to the bathroom whenever you want, and it's your own bathroom.
If Kim was pole vaulting, would you go and see him?
Invited him over, but it's like, no, I'm not going to stay in my room.
Well, listen, guys, lovely to speak to you. Have a great gig tonight.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, Soundgarden.
Thank you.
This summer, Absolute Radio Live will be bigger than ever. Coldplay, Elbow, Kasabian, Blur, Paul Weller, Florence, I Can't Keep Up, No, Stereophonics, The Stone Roses, and lots more. You'll be with them at this year's biggest live music events when you listen to Absolute Radio Live. We'll take you there.